Oh
that
yes, sir. I will be sending you my dad's number. My WhatsApp number is in for the call.
yeah, so
Yeah,
it's
my single yes, sir.
yeah, so it says it cannot receive calls and all that. So there is chance that I will stay in either as a quarantine prisoner for
Okay.
few days,
Okay.
or maybe they will allow me to move freely. So depends what happens. But if my flight is not cancelled, I'm coming to Jorhat tomorrow.
Okay, sir. We'll meet you then. Yeah, at last you're coming.
Yeah, twice my flight got cancelled, so it's
Yeah.
a helpless situation.
So it is live. So Sanjay, you can also share it in your page. I'm going to share it. It's live on another page right now.
Our page is really reaching high, like 3,549 post reaches every day. Really good.
Thanks to you.
Yeah. 643 post engagement.
That's So, Milin, how do you share the live thread on
Okay.
the Care Northeast page?
Okay. So you can go to Enerzery page. In Enerzery page, you will see it live and just click share and just post it. Or
The Enerzery page.
Or I can send you the link if you want.
Please do. Please send the link. That's, I think, easier.
Here you go. I'm sending it.
Yeah, I can see. Okay, I can share it from here, huh? Okay, I got it.
Deshraj was quite serious, and he went through and he shared the content that he wanted to share.
So we are just a couple of minutes away from starting our session. Just wanted to know, is Deshraj here? I can't see him on the Zoom, so I'm little. Maybe he's not able to connect.
Let me also reach out to him.
Sorry, my tea. I'll switch up the सफेद चना या काला चना? So, hello.
Hello,
Hi, Deshraj. Welcome. Shall we just wait for a couple of minutes?
sir. It's already 10.
Yeah, I know it is already 10. Maybe generally, you know, being in Assam with Lahel latitude and Indian standard time, if you put these two together, you will suddenly get to start on a Swiss time. So, Priyansu, can you mute everybody so that we don't? Yeah, we don't really.
Start video, no?
Sanjay, I muted you also, I guess. Sanjay, you are mute, so you can start.
Okay. So, welcome everybody. This is the third or fourth session, Milind, right?
No, this is the ninth or tenth session. We are starting from April 18. What are you talking about?
Okay, so maybe I just too focused on waste management.
Yeah.
So this is probably the ninth or tenth session. What we are trying to do is to connect different dots, particularly with the focus on Northeast India, that how we can make it more prosperous, how we can create a healthier life. Today we have a very prominent person, but probably very quiet, so not many people know about him. He runs an organization that promotes green energy. And I welcome Mr. Desraj Barua on the platform. Today he will talk about green energy. This platform is a collaborative platform of Energy, which I call which Milind leads, and I call connecting the dots. He is a great connector, connecting different people from different walks of life, trying to see how they can bring a lot of energy, a lot of investment, a lot of potentials, and have a better life than what we have today. I'm not saying it is bad, but we are trying to improve it. Along with Milind, we have Ori Kalankani, an organization that works on mental aspect and also on menstrual hygiene. So this platform is basically trying to diffuse both in terms of knowledge outreach as well as trying to bring in some real talents who would be willing to work in Northeast. And with this, I welcome Desraj and request him to give a short introduction. Desraj, I've already told you that he works with green energy, very passionate about what he does, and he's setting a biomethanization plant in Tezpur, probably the first in Northeast. If I'm right, Desraj, please correct me. And of a size that you don't see in many states. It's a 5-ton capacity plant from going waste to energy. And he's the one who's leading it in Assam. So Desraj, welcome to the platform. And please give us an introduction about a little bit about yourself. Why did you get interested in green energy? Or to be very specific, in waste to energy, a subject that is not talked about much in Northeast India. And what is your vision for the Northeast India? Desraj, the platform is yours. Desraj, you can go ahead. It seems that Desraj can't hear us. Is there some problem? Desraj, can you please write, because we are not able to hear you. Milind, Priyansu, can you hear me? Everybody is mute. So, Milind, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. And Desraj is unmuted, so he should be able to hear you.
But we can't hear him. He's trying to speak. But Desraj, can you hear us? I don't think Deshraj can hear us.
Okay, that's Deshraj. You need to shut down other app if it's on, so that or you can also put the video off so that you have enough bandwidth. Okay. I'll call him. He's saying something.
It seems like audio is probably muted because it shows unmute from our side.
Right, Basu. I think so, that he's either his jack is not properly inserted, because yeah, he can neither hear us nor can we hear him. So that means there is some problem with his audio jack.
Sanjay, I will talk to Deshraj. Meantime, can you talk a little bit about care in notice and about yourself, and I will mute myself and try to talk with Des.
Yes. Rather than that, probably I will. What I'll do, I would really request all the participants to give a short introduction of this themselves and just tell us in a sentence why you are here. What interests you in waste to energy or green energy that you are attending this webinar? Jinat, you can go. Jinat left, which I did not mean. We have Badal Prasad, if you would like to introduce yourself.
Yes, yeah. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Badal.
Basically, we all know that we are going kind of climate crisis and kind of many climate issues. Mm-hmm. Every day-to-day life, there is a kind of news that this forest is going to be cut down, these valleys in this trade of losing diversity and everything. So coming up with kind of renewable energy would really help us to stop kind of deforestation, kind of saving the biodiversity. So knowing about it, I could talk to my friends, my family members, and hopefully some awareness
Thank
among
you.
Us.
Thank you, Bhavan. That's quite good to know that.
Thank you so much.
Deshraj, can you still hear us, or you are not able to hear us? Because we certainly can't hear you. Priyanshu, if you'd like to introduce yourself in a sentence.
Yeah, I'm Priyanshu Kashyap. I am working with Friday for Future since a year now. And I would like to work on waste management, and I'm really happy that I met Sanjay sir and Milind sir. And I hope we'll be doing something soon. That's it.
We will. Bhavijyoti, please introduce yourself and why you are here on this platform today. Bhavijyoti, can we unmute? Bhavijyoti, you need to unmute. Yeah, go ahead. Bhavijyoti, can you hear us?
I think he's mute.
No, Bhavijyoti is not mute. We have Marina, if that's the right name. Marina, can you introduce yourself? Who is unmute?
Hello.
Marina, welcome. Yep.
Hello, good morning, everyone. My name is Marina. I'm from Priscilla Center. So today, why I'm here is that because since it is very practical these days, due to lockdown and all, there are so many things. So recently, we have been planning on working with organic farming. So I think renewable energy, green energy is very practical in today's time. That's why I wanted to know with someone who is actually working on it. So that will be very helpful. Thank you.
Thank you, Marina. Deshraj, are you online and can you hear us? Deshraj, we still can't hear you. Can anybody else hear Deshraj?
No, sir.
No, nobody. It's a little unfortunate with these technicalities, because just before this webinar started, I spoke with him and it was pretty clear and I could hear him. We had a short exchange, but unfortunately right now he's struggling with some technical difficulties. We have Basu. If Basu would like to introduce herself.
Sure. Hi everyone, Basu here. I work as a data scientist and live in the United States. I connected with Milan, Sanjay and Priyanshu last week and found out that they have been doing some really interesting work. I come from Assam. I grew up in Assam, so I'm definitely very interested to be involved in work back home. And this webinar particularly, I think you generally see energy with associated with big companies, like big organizations doing stuff with energy. So it's really interesting to see someone like Deshraj starting his own project and looking forward. Hopefully the technology cooperates to learn more about that.
Thanks, Basu. We look forward to share some good news in the next 6 months. Both Deshraj. Deshraj, can you hear us now?
I think so. He can try calling from us from his Zoom app, from his phone, I guess.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, now we are audible.
All right.
Sorry. I think it was some issue with my laptop. I think I'm. It's okay. I'll be giving.
Great. So let me just repeat. You are welcome on the platform.
Yeah.
And we already have given an introduction, and since we have lost few minutes no problem. That's something beyond our control. So we'd like to tell us a little bit about yourself, what interests you in green energy, and what is your vision for the Northeast when you started all this? With what were the thoughts that came to your mind, and with what vision you were working with? Welcome, Deshraj.
Yeah. See, vision wise. I never thought of anything of like vision. So I started this work in 2014. So at that time, I knew nothing about biogas. I knew nothing about renewable energy. But this project clicked me something. And, I was very much downward from my beginning. From my childhood, I always like animals. I always like birds. I always wanted to be attached with the nature, nothing else. So eventually, time passed on. We studied the project. Then finally, this year we are able to commission this project. This project is around 45,000. We have the capacity to treat 45,000 organic waste daily and to produce near about 720 kilowatts of electricity per hour, 24/7. And we can replicate these kind of projects two in Upper Assam, one in Lower Assam, and probably two, three in Arunachal. And we have this project in pipeline. So in coming 5 years, we can definitely multiply these projects. This will definitely help people treating organic waste. And the most important thing is segregation in biogas. Hello, am I still audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
We can hear you very clearly. Please go ahead.
Yeah. So should I start with what I'm here?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah. See, renewable energy is, everyone knows it's nothing new. There are different types of renewable energy. The first is solar, then it comes wind, then it comes hydro, then it comes biomass. Solar, everyone knows, solar panels are installed, facing the sun, which have electrodes, photovoltaic cells, which are charged to produce electricity. It is a very clean form of electricity that doesn't emit any smoke or anything. This solar can be connected by two ways. It is off-grid and on-grid. Off-grid is what which is the...
Yes, do you want to share your PowerPoint?
Yeah, please. Yeah.
So you can just click on the share screen. I already give you permission. You can share the screen. So on the below, you have share screen and then click sharing screen. So you will be able to share it.
Okay, let me try.
If you go to the bottom, you will see different icons and one in the middle is share screen.
I cannot see that. Oh yes, share. Let's try once. That is not the PPT is not with in the mobile, so it's difficult me to share in here.
All right, I will share it. Okay, yeah. I will share this screen.
Okay. Are you sharing it now?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you go to the second slide?
All right, just one.
Let's understand the types of renewable energy. There are mainly six important renewable energy, that is solar, then come winds, then come hydro, then biomass, tidal, and geothermal. But in India, the above four are popular in India. Let's go to the third slide. Sorry, fourth. Let's understand how solar power works. We all know sun emits radiant energy. The solar panels have electrolytes, photovoltaic cells, which charge to generate electricity. But there are some challenges while generating power from solar, that weather issue, space issue, because it requires lots of space. For generating 1 kilowatt of solar, we need around 10 square meter of space. Then comes the wind. Wind energy is here. Wind is treated as an object. There are big fans. Big fans are attached with dynamo or turbine, what we call. Then there are some engineering work involved in it. Then when the blades of the fan. When the fan rotates, it also rotates the turbine attached to it. Then at a certain RPM, electricity is produced. Generally, it requires 1500 RPM to generate electricity. It is good for coastal area. Now the engineers have come up with ideas for on course and off course also. That means on course, it means they have started erecting these windmills middle of the sea, so that the wind they get in continuously, and continuously the electricity is produced. This is a one-time investment. This is the way the solar and the windmill works. There's a rotary blade. The wind comes, and it when it passes through the blade, the gearbox attached to the generator used to rotate. Then electricity is produced. Then electricity is synchronized, and they are fitted in the electricity grid. Can you go to the next? Hydril here is the same as the windmill, but designs are a bit different. Again, here generators are rotated with the help of water. Means when there is a flow of water, these dynamo are attached in such a way that when the water falls, it hits the other part of the generator, and it starts to rotate the generator, and it produces the electricity. Then here comes the most important thing: the biomass, in which I am working, is the biogas. Before learning biogas, we should understand what is biomass. Biomass means anything which is living object. It may be human, animal, plant, tree, whatever it is. Example, as a fuel source of biomass is grass, cow dung, food waste, vegetable, human waste, etc. Biomass is considered as a renewable source of energy because, unlike any fossil fuel, it doesn't add any carbon to our carbon footprint. Can you go to the second? Biomass conversion classification. See, to derive energy, this biomass has to go through a certain procedure. There are three kinds of conversion procedure. That is thermal. It's like directly burning the object, or it's a pyrolysis or gasification. Then it comes the chemical one, fissure thoroughfares. Then it comes the third one, the biochemical. Now the project which I am doing, it comes under the biochemical one. There you can see a anaerobic digestion. To collect methane, which is our source of fuel to generate electricity, is methane. Biogas component produced from anaerobic digester. In simple words, what we can say, biogas produce contains methane, hydrogen, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and other impurities. Then the first three, please go ahead. Yeah, the first three gases which contributes produce electricity. In short, we can term it as fuel. So to combat a engine, the first three gas are important. Can you go to the next one, slide? To generate electricity, methane is required up to 60%. Between 50% to 60%, methane is required to combat the engine, so that engine runs and they produce electricity. After biogas is produced, it is passed through a scrubber to remove all the impurities, and then dried. There is a moisture trap through which the gas is passed. It is used as a fuel to generate electricity. To generate electricity. Can you go to the third one? Yeah. So then we come to the point: how to make biogas. To make biogas, we need a digester first. digester is a place where biomass are filled and leave to decompose in absence of oxygen. A certain temperature is required for the biomass to decompose. It should be a uniform temperature. It has to be maintained 24/7 throughout the year. Good temperature for digestion is between 30 to 32 degrees Celsius. Yeah, the type. Let's come to the type of digester. This is a fixed dome digester. This is all made of concrete. It is. We have to be very careful while filling this, so that there is a space left, so that the digestion, the chemical procedure is done, and there is space to collect the methane or other gases. You know, second one. Yeah. This is a floating drum biogas plant. If you can see this metal thing, when gas is produced, it comes up. It used to inflate. It used to come towards upside. When it comes upside, we understand that the gas is being produced. Yeah. Can you go to the second one? Yeah. This is the membrane type of digester. A membrane type of digester is good, and it is required only when digester are made for commercial uses, like more than 120 cubic meter plant. So this kind of membranes are here. For membrane, there are two types of membrane. There's an upper membrane and there's an inner membrane. Inner membrane collects the gas, but the upper membrane is like a shield. It used to work as a shield. It used to protect the inner membrane from sunlight, from rain, and so that the gas does not deteriorate quickly. For gas production, culture of bacteria is required, which we call as methanol bacterium, collectively known as methazone. It requires up to 45 days in ideal temperature to culture or to build up their colony. After that, it's a daily process, daily feeding, and daily output is achieved. For gas, feedstock is very important. Some feedstock takes a longer period of time to decompose to produce gas, and some feedstock requires less time to produce gas. Cow dung requires less than 72 hours to produce gas, but same feedstock like green manure will require up to 15 days to decompose and to produce methane. And nowadays people are working on rice husk, and they have found it has to be mixed with algae and to feed the digester, and it takes up to 45 days to decay and to produce methane. Let's quickly go through a process flow of biogas. Cattle dung are need to be mixed with water like ghol. It has to be perfectly mixed so that feeding is done to the digester. Wheat, grass, vegetable leftover should be chopped in uniform way, so that it can be mixed with slurry and can be fed to the digester. The most important thing, the digester should be airtight and should be absence of oxygen. after certain period, gas will start to produce in fixed dome. We've already discussed it. Can you go to the next slide?
Milin.
I am in the next slide. I skipped the previous slide and you're talking about gas usage.
Yeah. I will answer the question after finishing this. Is it okay?
Yes.
Yeah. When gas is produced, it has to be used somewhere. First of all, easiest way to use biogas is use it in kitchen, use it as cooking gas. If the pressure is low, it can be boosted up by putting small blower, or we can call it a gas booster. Secondly, we can produce electricity. Nowadays, lots of companies coming with good engines. Engines with PLCs, engine small generators, 2 kilowatt, 3 kilowatt generators are here, and biogas or methane can also be used in vehicles. When these gas are compressed and are filled in a cylinder, it is a good clean source of fuel for cooking, for vehicle, for dryer, anything. Can you go to the next one?
And that's it. I don't have anything else.
Okay.
Thanks, Dastraj. This is just like being in a classroom learning how the biogas operates. Just to bring in the focus on why we are here and probably talk a little more about waste to energy. If we see that India has a rich history of biogas, it has started in 1970s, and we saw household biogas plants, we saw commercial biogas plants, we saw village level community based biogas plants. Today in India, if you see, we are generating biogas for as a cooking, biogas at the commercial level for electricity, biogas at CNG at Indore and also in Pune. But why is not getting popular? Everybody talks about it. Everybody knows that this is a really good system for managing green waste, organic waste, whether it is cow dung, municipal organic waste, or just agri-bio waste. What is preventing this system from getting popular or by getting adopted by the people who matter?
It is not that people are not interested, but the main problem is the finance. It requires lots of investment, up cost in investment. So that is the problem. But the government are trying to populate it by giving more and more subsidy. Up to 50% subsidies are offered in biogas. Punjab is, I have to say, Punjab is doing very good in bio CNG and waste to electricity. They have done tremendous. They have made such a platform. They have suppliers for cow dung. They have suppliers for waste. They have done tremendous work in segregation. That's it. But where it is not popular, that people don't know what to segregate and how to segregate. That is the most problematic thing I have faced in last 5 years.
Can you tell us a little more about your project, how it is financed, what capacity it is, who will be the end user, and who is financing it, what kind of investments were required, and anything beyond these three or four things that I've asked that can enlighten the general public what kind of challenges one faces when setting up a biogas plant?
First of all, we have to get a very decent plot. Plot has to be selected very carefully because the digester is a huge one. We have to taste the soil first. If it is sandy loamy soil, then it is not good for constructing the digester, because digester size is like 25 meter into 3 meter, which is a huge one. So we have to dig up to around 3 meters to take out all the sandy loamy soil, and we have to fill up with all sand gravels. Then we could construct the digester. That was the first challenge. The second challenge was getting the finance. Finance was it took us around 2 years to get finance. Finally, we got finance from an PSU bank. Then there are subsidies from MNRE, there are subsidies from NEEDS, but subsidies are released after the commercial and commissioning of the plant. The challenges we faced was the raw material. There are abundance of raw material. Wherever you go, you'll find cow dung, heaps of cow dung everywhere. But thing is that people don't know how to treat the waste. For me, waste is best, or waste is the future. I have seen vendors coming up with loads of trucks with cow dung, but with cow dung we used to get sandals, we used to get packets of gutka, we used to get bricks, stones, what not. With that impurities, they are jammed in the pipelines. We have machinery breakdowns. So we have faced a lot of problems. So now we have educated the vendors. We have gone to the household, understanding people why it is important to us, how we have to treat the waste, how we have to keep the cow dung, and for how long they can keep, and within what time period it should be delivered to our plant. The most, I would say, the most funny was working with the army. They wanted to lead the Amar Jyoti with methane. They called me, then I went and I gave the design. It was like costing them around 24 lakhs to build 120 cubic meter biogas plant. So then I gave them an idea, you give me waste, I will give you clean fuel. Then they sent me the very third day, they sent me 3 loads of trucks full of plastic. Then I told them, we don't want plastic. They said, you need waste, and we are giving you waste. So these are the problems we are facing. So it will take time to people understand how to segregate waste.
What is the feasibility of having biogas plants? Traditionally, biogas has been associated with cow dung or any animal dung, let's say that. But in terms of managing municipal organic waste and agro waste, how do you see the possibilities? We have a question from Badal that more cow dung means more CO2 emissions. So how do you balance? Can it be truly called renewable energy then?
Yeah, that was written in my slide. Let me go through it.
You can just tell us, no problem.
Yeah, it was biomass is considered as a renewable source of energy because unlike any fossil fuel, it doesn't add any carbon emission to our carbon footprint. Is it, did you get it?
Yes, sir, I got it.
Yeah. See.
The nature.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, if we burn a tree and it emits smoke and carbon, we are not adding any new carbon to our carbon footprint, because eventually the tree will grow and it will one day it will fall down and it will start decaying. By this or die, by that mean that tree will add that much carbon to the environment, environment, whether we are burning it or it is decaying it by itself. So there is no point of adding more carbon using cow dung or cows. It is natural.
We have a question from Basu, and she's asking, how do you supply to customers? Do you develop the delivery pipelines for the gas? So what is the method of supplying it to the customer?
Supplying to the customer, we are not supplying to customer at the moment. We are using this gas to generate electricity. Yes, we have project in pipeline to compress the gas, which is called bio-CNG, and it can be put into cylinder and we can deliver it to customers. But pipeline, it is not feasible for us at the moment. It will require lots of pipings, lots of boosters. This is not feasible at the moment for us.
There is a question from Devajit where he says that Assam is always suffering from electricity deficit. Yeah. Are you optimistic about it that this can be another suitable alternative?
Yeah, it is suitable. It is suitable, but people should segregate their waste at source.
And maybe Devajit, I can add, the quantity that you are currently talking about to fill in the deficit is not what biogas can supply to. The biogas is primarily a technology to convert waste into energy. So it supplements your grid supply, but on its own, it cannot be alternative which can fulfill all the demands.
Can you repeat?
I was responding to Devajit that it's a supplement to grid supply. It cannot be an independent source of energy that can be used by all the consumers. So because our sources of input material is limited, which is waste, whether it is cow dung or biomass. So our sources of inputs are limited. So we'll have to rely on conventional grid supply electricity.
Here, I would like to draw your attention. In South, there is a fish market, and through their waste of the fish, after the market, they used to put in the digester, and they used to run a generator, and they with that electricity, all the shopkeepers are getting electricity, but for a limited period of time. That is after dawn, after dark.
But that's true. It's there in Tarangambadi, it's there in Trichy, in Tamil Nadu, Tarangambadi, near Chennai. It's there in Trivandrum. So this is something, Milin, we wanted to develop for the Vipanna Kendra, where we haven't made much progress, but this is why I was suggesting a biogas plant, more like for cooking gas than supplying electricity. Because if you are just complementing, then it's not good enough. But we saw that.
Yeah, Honda, Caterpillar, then MTU, now Force is coming with some small, good, compact biogas generators. We just need to purchase them. First of all, we have to make the digester. We have to collect the gas. We have to feed the generator. We have to make no alteration in the diesel generator. It is in the market now for all the digesters.
Sanjay, I have a question.
Yes, so I asked him.
Yeah. So how much that that digester must have cost in the fish market? Like how much? What we're talking about?
No, it depends upon the size.
But the fish market, because I'm thinking about, like, you're talking about Vipanna Kendra, right?
what will be the total waste? It will proportionately depend upon the waste they are producing.
So I'm talking like about kilos. In Punjabi, in they fly over.
I know. But
so how much it will cost, sir?
We are looking at half a ton, this Raj, 500 kg per day of production. But there is also a possibility to bring it to upscale it to 1 ton level by bringing waste from the nearby hotels.
One ton will be something like, what I'll say, it will be like around 2 cubic meters. 2 cubic to 2.5 cubic meter gas plant. This won't cost us more.
Just to give an idea to the audience that what is that much means, 8 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, what does it mean?
Around 5 lakhs?
Max. Around 5 lakhs. Yeah. So with a 5 lakh cost, we can manage 1 ton of waste, right?
Yes, we can. And including the generator.
And to understand in a very simpler terms, how many LPG, 14 kg LPG tanks of cooking gas can be produced from 1 ton of waste?
That I have to calculate.
Okay.
if all the viewers can download biogas app from the Play Store, they will get half of the answer from that app.
That's a very good. Information. I did not know there is a biogas app on Play Store.
Yeah, I'm being invited to be a member of Indian Biogas Association.
Superb. Yeah, that's superb. From the audience, if there is more questions, please throw your questions to Desraj. I think we were having a very, very rich information source today. So we truly appreciate if somebody is interested to know more, whether technically or in terms of financial models, in terms of technical models or conceptually. I'll have a question which you can answer at the end. I've seen thousands and thousands of home biogas systems. Yeah. And some of them I would really love to put it in Tinsukia. I've been promoting community biogas systems for the hostels. I just set up one in Siliguri in a school called GD Goenka by hiring a company from Kolkata. And I would like to ideally set up such biogas systems for every hostel that is there in a school. So what are your thoughts on that? How can we popularize it? But before you ask me, audience, please ask your questions.
I would like to add one thing. If all the individuals think and if the government wants to popularize biogas, there will be a huge impact on Indian economy. India has the capacity to reduce import of hydrocarbon up to 15%. That Sanjay sir can easily figure out what is the amount, what will be the saving, 15% of total hydrocarbon import.
Hydrocarbon. So it seems that we don't have many questions. So would you like to answer that? How do we promote home composting and community composting, particularly also in the context of the schools which have hostels, which are residentials?
I always believe we should target students from class 8 to class 12. They are our future. They should understand what is biogas. And once they get the taste of biogas and fertilizer from their own waste, they will never ever allow their parents to buy and go cylinder from their gas agency. We have to educate our future. We have to educate the children. We have to, the audience here should be from class 8 to class 12. At that period of time, there are lots of deviations. They want to show off. If that showing off are in track, then this will be brilliant. Yeah. Hydrogen power. Yeah. I want to take this question. Hydrogen power. Yeah.
Yeah, it says, I guess you can read it. Hydro power is a renewable energy, but it
it's a contradictory. I never ever advocate hydropower as a renewable energy when it comes to the question of deforestation. Never. Small one, yes, it is always a renewable energy. Small jharna coming down. If you can put the lead there, it rotates, it produces electricity, that is good. But deforesting these hills and cutting down trees and making hydropower, I will never advocate, and I don't want to. Yeah.
So I have a question. So yeah. When you talk about the biogas, the input to the biogas, yeah. I wanted to understand a little bit more. So you are saying that cow dung. So what is the percent of cow dung? What is the percent of feedstock? When you say the feedstock, I assume that you mean grass and stuff like that, right?
The feedstock is collective. Feedstock is collective of cow dung, green manure, wheat, food, leftover, vegetable, anything which is
So what is the percentage wise? So tomorrow I wanted to start, for example. So what should be the, and I think I assume that you have to put water also. So what is the percentage wise, the input?
Make it 60-40.
60% what?
60% solid, 40% water.
Okay. So I think I have mentioned a long time back, we used to have cow and we used to have biogas, and government had given, I think that time, it's almost 20 years ago or maybe more. Almost 25 years ago,
we
used to have that where the tank go up. I forgot whatever name you said.
Floating dome.
Yeah, floating. And government is to give subsidize that, like, you know.
Yeah.
But I don't see it anymore right now. So my question is that, so many of us work with animal rescue, for example, and say tomorrow we have animal sanctuary. Can you use the dog poop to produce biogas? Or what about human poop? Because as you are creating, I think we need more restroom or toilet. Listen to my question first. We need many toilets. You know, people, women, guys goes and just pee everywhere as if this whole India is just a toilet everywhere, right? So it, of course, boils my head. So I think that the guys, as soon as they try to open their jib, they think about their wife, because their wife also may be liking to go. So for my point is that we should have more toilets, and making that more toilet available, I'm just thinking how could that human poop can generate power, electricity, so that it may be able to reduce some cost or something like that. So could you talk about all kind of poop, like dog poop, human poop, and, you know, how could you use that?
See, human poops are treated with no contaminations. It should be, the thing is that the poop should directly go to the digester with no impurities, and we'll get good amount of methane. I think the methane will go up to 70% with ammonia, and definitely, yes, we can cook out of that fuel, we can generate electricity of that fuel, but I'm sure people will not like me saying this. We can use our poop to cook and again to eat and again poop.
No, but there are good examples. The Tambram plant is based on human
sewage.
Poop.
Yeah.
No, there is a community toilet, and beside the community toilet, they have constructed a biogas plant. And besides that, there is a community kitchen where people come and cook their food. It's a slum area in Tambram.
So, okay.
And that is not the only plant in India. There are several plants where either they purely run on human poop, or they make some amount of cow dung and organic waste generated at the household level to generate gas and is supplied to number of households. In Satkhira, I'm working for last 3 years. I'm working on Satkhira is in Bangladesh. With two plants where we use human poop plus cow dung and plus municipal organic waste to generate cooking gas. and supply it individually to the household with a meter. So the technology exists and it's a doable thing, but it's just that the municipality or the government doesn't have that much of patience to work on this.
No, the problem was with the E. coli first. Yeah, the second, first problem was the E. coli. The second was how to handle it, because there are certain protocols to handle the digested night soil.
Right.
The what we call the prescribed separating line is to be different, and some automation is required in picking the fertilizer. It cannot be used as fertilizer. It can be used any alternate way. Like it can be made particle boards or landfilling. But there are certain protocols to handle the digested nitrogen, as far as I know.
They are being used in brick making, which is quite safe.
Yes.
So and the quantity. Yeah, the quantity of residue is not that big, so it's not difficult to handle.
So what was the recovery percentage?
Recovery of gas?
Slurry.
I don't have the
slurry.
I have to look at to the report that what is the percentage of that.
Please see if it is not more than 5%.
I can check that out, but
please let me know. Yeah.
So any more questions?
Daljit was asking something.
Daljit is saying, I have experienced people preferring firewood over biogas in many villages, as biogas takes much longer to cook compared to other sources of energy.
Yeah.
Good question, Daljit.
Yeah, it depends upon the calorific value, because LPG or this has limited. In that point, we can put one small booster in the pipeline, depending upon the size of the cooking stove, 0.5, 0.25, 0.1, that will clear the problem.
Yeah, basically, Daljit, it depends how much the biogas is purified. The more purified it is, the better the flame and the temperature. But if you use it raw, it is a slow cooking. That's no doubt about it. Because in the village,
the flow is very low.
Yeah,
we have to boost it up.
Yes, the flow is low in the traditional way, but if you use a booster, then you can get a better flow and a better temperature. Anything else? Desraj, just let me know if there is a possibility through any sources to set up for demonstration couple of home biogas systems and a school system.
Yes, definitely. Daljit here is actually my friend. He's doing PhD from Tezpur University. So we are closely working with Tezpur University to develop small micro digesters. Even I have developed 2-3 models of small digesters. I have used it. I have used a 500 liter Syntex tank in making digester to popularize it. So the cost will be nothing. Cost will be like 5,000 to 5,500 for 1 hour of cooking daily.
Okay, that's very good to know. Once you are confident of that, I would like to set up a few of them in Tinsukia. And to Milin especially, and somebody else if wants to, I would really like to demonstrate these technologies in the context of the schools, because this is where our ideas germinate. If kids see today biogas working in a school canteen or a school midday meal program, they will be much more excited when they grow up, both in terms of segregation and how to produce energy. So if somebody is willing to do that, I would love to handle it in the schools that I'm currently working with.
This could be a good project for this student. They could be intern or IIT student, right? Because we often have interns. And I was thinking about when we started this midway journey, we used to clean Uzan Bazar Ghat. And Uzan Bazar Ghat, there's a market over there. And the market has lots of waste. And quite often those waste, and also in Uzan Bazar, people go to after people, you know, somebody die, you know, they do the ritual over there. And there's lots of, material like banana leaves and flowers and all that. Even in the temples, Kamakha temples and, Ugratara and all this temple could have biogas, right? You know, because they create so much of organic waste, and we should be, I'd love to think more about that and see how we could collaborate with the government, and need to know more about small scale. So I have the question about Deshraj. Yeah. Now you are working with the army and you produce this gas. So who is your customer? Who is buying? And what is your company's goal, 5 years and 10 years goal? What are they planning to do?
Our end user is APDCL. We have power purchase agreement, 25 years irrevocable agreement with APDCL at a certain rate to supply them electricity. Then for the fertilizer part, we are still struggling to find buyers.
Okay. So what is the price, like per kilowatt? What does...
I'm keeping it same as vermicompost rate.
I mean, I do not know vermicompost rate. I'm asking about compared to my electricity
eight
rate.
Rupees, between 8 rupees to 10 rupees.
Okay.
It has been an hour. So if there are no more questions, maybe... we can finally close it. Priyanshu, if you are there, would you like to say something before we close?
No, sir, it's fine. It is really Milen,
final words from you.
Well, I'm very happy that Deshraj was able to join us. And it was coincident, coincident that I came to know about you and your work. And I'm really happy that our team is slowly growing. Uh-huh. Priyanshu has been helping me, and then Vashu joined. Now Sanjay is joining, and hopefully we'll reach out to more and more people. There's lots of people watching in Facebook. So Deshraj, keep on doing good work, and we wanted to use up all this dung, whether human dung or dog dung or anybody's dung. We would love to know more about it, and let's say that every waste, there's nothing called waste. Then that we can clean.
We have to treat it as a black gold.
Yes.
We definitely agree. So with the final words, thank you, Deshraj. I'll look forward to set up a couple of biogas plants, both at household level as well as community and school level. I look forward to see you very soon. Thank you, Milen. Thank you, Priyanshu. And thank you, everybody, for joining us for this very enriching session on biogas, waste to energy, what we also call green energy. Deshraj, truly grateful to you for joining us. Milen, for organizing you. And Ori Kalankili for giving us the platform. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hello.